Hello well-wishers and welcome to my channel Aspiring Minds. In today's video, we are going to discuss a famous short story called The Last Leaf, written by O. Henry. So grab your virtual seats and let's begin decoding the meaning of it. O. Henry, who was born by the name William Sidney Potter, was an American short story writer. He was known for his clever use of wordplay and surprise endings. His works often explore the complexities of human nature and the unpredictability of life. Now, The Last Leaf is set in an old house during the season of autumn. Two young artists, Sue and Johnsy, live together. Johnsy falls seriously ill with pneumonia, becoming convinced that she will die when the last leaf falls from an ivy creeper outside the window of the house. Sue is very desperate to save her friend and she tries various methods to distract and uplift Johnsy's spirits. So now let's see what's there in store in the story. Now Johnsy, we know, is seriously ill with pneumonia. She's convinced that there's a last leaf that she's seeing. Rather, there is an ivy creeper just opposite her house. She can see it from the window and it is losing leaves. And she believes that when the last leaf falls, she's going to die. Now at this time, Sue engages in various attempts to distract her friend from thinking about these weird things about the life's end. Now, despite the efforts made by Sue, Johnsy still remains stuck in that thought process of the falling leaves. Now at this time, Sue seeks the help of Behram, who's an old painter living in the same building. Now Behram comes with an idea, who initially does not like this mindset of Johnsy, and then he agrees to help. He is determined to create a masterpiece and he paints a leaf on the ivy creeper during one night where it was very stormy. Now tragically, what happens is, because he was painting outside, Behram himself succumbs to pneumonia. After this selfless act of painting out a leaf to save the life of Johnsy. Now the last leaf that was painted by Behram miraculously is able to survive the storm. It does not get destroyed by the effects of the storm, and Johnsy, witnessing the last leaf and how it has been able to stand the test of the storm, re-evaluates, tries to rethink about her outlook, her perspective on life. Now Johnsy realizes the value of life and the impact of her negative mindset. Sue shares Behram's sacrifice with Johnsy, leading to a change in Johnsy's attitude. So you see how external situations have an impact on a person's mindset. But ultimately, there's something that happens with Behram. The doctor reveals that Behram is no more, emphasizing the selflessness of his final artistic act. He painted a leaf to save Johnsy's life, and in return, he himself died from pneumonia. Now, the last leaf, therefore, becomes a symbol of hope, resilience, and the endearing impact of genuine human connections. Let us quickly discuss the major themes of the poem. Now, Puri serves as a symbolic backdrop which represents how there is existence of spirituality and cultural richness on one hand, and the reality of life, creating many layers to the poem. Now added to this, we have the theme of faith and despair, because we see there is coexistence of faith and despair, depicting individuals who are seeking peace and guidance on a spiritual level on one hand, and on the other hand, there are people who are still struggling to fulfill the basic necessities of their life. Next, it talks about mortality and transience. The poem delves into the theme of mortality using the powerful imagery of decay, death, and funeral pyres. Next, it also talks about socioeconomic disparity, divide or difference, because we see how surrounded by the great temple at Puri are the poverty-stricken individuals who are trying to find a place in society by just trying to eat something to have their basic necessities sorted out. And lastly, we see how the poem talks about personal and collective suffering. That is, it gives descriptions of individuals who are facing hardships, and it is also showing a collective suffering. How we see that the poem mentions there are crouched faces without names. So the poem explores both on a personal level and on a collective level that each human being is suffering, whether it is on a spiritual level, physical level, whatever it is. But the basic necessity is to have accommodation for humanity, to have a sensitivity for human beings. Now see, what are the major themes of the poem? The poem incorporates the character of the crow, who symbolizes both creation and destruction at the same time, right? Now, in the background to this, we have the first thing, that is excessive pride and defeat. The poem is going to explore this theme and as to how the crow, because of being extremely proud and arrogant, attempts to challenge the sun but ultimately faces defeat. This theme reflects on the consequences of unchecked pride. If you do not check yourself, you are proud of unknown random reasons, it will bring downfall. Second, it talks about nature's indifference. That is, the natural world represented by the sun is portrayed as being ignorant, indifferent to the challenge of the crow. Nature follows its own course, and attempts to defy or manipulate nature will often result in bad results. That is, when the crow challenged the sun, what happened? It tried to manipulate the sun. The crow could not win. Ultimately, nature was victorious. Thirdly, the black and white symbolism. The contrast between white and black in the poem suggests that the crow's victory is in a realm where white is black and white. Black is white suggests a complete paradox, a contrast that exists in the understanding of victory and defeat. These two terms, the crow feels, can be used interchangeably because he is not ready to accept his defeat. And lastly, we also learn about the cyclical nature of life, where the crow's bold act of challenging the sun is followed by his own charred, cold, black-like state. This reflects on the broader theme of life, death, and regeneration. Now, based on our analysis of the poem, we see that the primary focus of the poet is rejecting the traditional notion of death and how people fear death, because done over here challenges that death might be perceived to be very powerful, but in reality that is not so, because the poem explores the nature of death, depicting it as a temporary sleep and not the ultimate end. Death is portrayed as a force which is not superior but rather inferior. It is incapable of truly destroying. The theme of eternal life is also the central theme of the poem, because Dunn expresses the Christian belief in life after death, asserting that death is not the end but a transition from the present state into an eternal existence, that is life after death. And lastly, of course, there is powerlessness of death, which is highlighted in the poem, portraying death as a slave to luck, chance, and human actions. Death is presented, therefore, as an inferior force compared to the eternal life which is promised by faith or religion. So, Death Be Not Proud is a powerful poem that challenges the traditional or the conventional notion of death and showing that there is ultimate victory of life over death. So, let us now discuss the major themes of this prose piece. We see hope and resilience. The last leaf symbolizes how there is hope and resilience in the face of adversity in life. Even when you are feeling extremely let down, there is always a ray of hope. There is always light at the end of the tunnel. You just have to make an effort, grab yourself up and walk that tunnel. Secondly, it talks about human connection, because we see how Sue supports her friend and at the same time Behram sacrifices his own life, which highlight how human connections were very, very important in people's life in those times. And lastly, Behram's final painting becomes a metaphor for the power of artistic expression and selfless creativity. Remember always, art survives the test of time. A person may die, but the art of that person lives forever. So that's it from this video. I hope you liked it. Do hit the like button. Subscribe to my channel for more such future updates. Thank you for watching. Bye.